how do you talk about sexual education? How do you talk about that? It's really something. So we feel during the perayaan kami kasih selip ini supaya kami punya community pun mulai dia berbincang soal ini. And if there is some kind that kind of issue happen in the community, mungkin yang sudah tinggal ini webinar ya kasih idea lah. Mungkin kopi anak masih di bawah umur. Then they do not see macam persoalan tadi itu pun karena juga tanya si Mon Jenny when she started to talk about Uli juga dikasih piara ke kawin ibu tunggal. I see from the feedback that they're not so happy lah Uli dan ibu tunggal begitu, tapi sebenarnya mereka tidak sedar that is available to us. Nah, and satu daripada setting menarik itu kajian adalah they leave the family very early for hijrahan, yeah. They are just about 13, 14, 15. They're supposed to be with their parents, but suddenly they get married, kan? They have to move to another family. They are sebenarnya banyak dia punya tekanan dan sebagainya. And so the vicious cycle continue lah. Dia tidak boleh menjadi ibu bapa yang bagus sebab dia masih muda. Dia tiada peluang pekerjaan untuk meningkatkan keluarga. Begitu, so, kami tidak boleh break ini cycle of poverty, Pak. So, I think indigenous community ourselves must be the one to break it, lah, untuk kurang dari itu.
I think just to add to that juga, ramai yang belum tahu bahwa actually you option dia ni adalah penting. You can have, you can give away your child for adoption or single mother. As I said, these are all accepted now.
Siapa soalan yang paling selalu, siapa lah bin ini anak dia pernah.
And also, they need to know a lot of things. Dia takut dia tidak boleh taruh nama bapa, itu boleh. You, even if you don't marry, you can put the name of the father.
Yeah, it's allowed.
You don't have to put your dia punya the perempuan punya mama, which is also something becoming very quite often di sini. You can put the name of the father kalau kau mau nama dia itu, tapi tidak semestinya kau
tahu.
That's all part of the law. Yeah. Banyak juga pemahaman tentang undang-undang ini, tapi pada masa yang sama juga mengetahui bahwa banyak option kita lah. Dan actually the good thing in the orang asal is accept, you are accepted. Misalnya kalau kau hamil dan kau bayar itu sogit, you are no longer top. Kita kena macam caci sudah bahwa
culture dia
sudah bahwa ya dia dia kawin. It's okay, you kalau sudah kawin, okay lah. Kau bayar, I mean, kalau sudah sogit, kita lagi kena cakap kau tidak kawin kenapa? Number one, number two, kalau dia bilang anak angkat ini memang dari dulu lagi. Sedangkan kalau saya tiada anak, kakak saya ada dua anak dan kasih saya, that's normal.
Itu praktis.
Praktis. So actually, no, ini sepatutnya orang asal tidak perlu takut lah. Dan of course ibu tunggal is new, but I think we've always had ibu tunggal lah all this time. So the first thing is actually that's why you said break away from the social norm yang mengikat kita sebagai orang asal lah. Then only we can go through that. So, and also things that poverty is also very rampant. So, biasa dia ingat, kasih kalau saya ada 10 anak, saya tidak boleh menjaga dia. Saya kasih, you know, like, kasih kawin awal. Ingat, this will solve the problem. Actually, it doesn't. The child continues to be in poverty. Mengikut itu kajian kami, all of them, yang majority, about 98% in 1,000 and below dia punya pendapatan. So, it's very sad. It doesn't help you to marry your child early, but yeah, it only perpetuate it. Imagine kalau kau punya anak itu kawin, sudah apa, they go back to school misalnya, then, I mean, maybe itu lagi lah, kalau dia, she committed one mistake maybe, and then got pregnant. A lot of because of that. Then, nanti kalau kasih dia, so the best is actually, kalau punya anak itu, kau jaga dia lagi, give her a little more, another chance, she will be able to contribute to your, actually your family. So, there's a lot of what I call the barriers kita inilah yang kita mesti share kepada orang asal supaya mereka merasa I'm sure you have to only bring you forward. Semakin meningkat, semakin meningkat.
Karena pergaulan bebas lah.
Pergaulan bebas. So, I think the other thing we haven't talked about is the social, social media. Sekarang anak-anak kita kan semua terdedah kepada social media. So, and mention it about parenting, which is true lah. Kita kena, I think also government has to step in. So that kita boleh control punya access to the media yang mungkin tidak sesuai untuk dia tidak paham. You must always remember their children. You always remember yang biasa ya kita lupa ini adalah ini hak. Of course anak-anak itu ada hak untuk dia punya access itu, tapi when it comes to actually sexual information, dia memang masih lagi tidak, dia perlu bimbingan dari kita. So, sekatan internet misalnya, parenting guide, all this are very important.
Berarti berdasarkan kajian paling awal yang dikawinkan, umur?
Ya, yang dapatan untuk kajian ini 12 tahun. 12 years, very young. But in one of the studies that is done by UNICEF, actually kami dapatkan melalui syariah, information from Ministry of Health, di mana dia apply untuk mau kawin kan, you have to go to the ministry, you have to go to the hospital to get HIV test kan. They found even 10 years old ada application untuk get married. So, but in this research is 12 years with the youngest. Kajian? Oh, ini kajian actually biayai oleh Kesatuan Eropa, European Union, dan dia buat tahun ini,
lima bulan. Actually, we started last year, about November, October, November.
Dan dia baru habis dari, I think 5 months only, and they finish. So, but it's only for 5 districts.
Lagi district.
So there are another 30 district to go through. District and sub-district. So that's the proposal I have put forward to UNICEF. Or maybe we can even try EU lagi untuk teruskan kajian. Sebab bagi saya, one of the biggest, people always ask lah, always the data. So now we have the data yang ada untuk lima district ini. If we can do another 30 more district, we have almost a complete picture lah. But yang lima ini memang yang Kaitan, Pitas, Kota Marudu, Tenem, Anak Bawan, ini memang yang kami tahu paling rendah, paling tinggi perkahwinan bawah umur. But the 30, even in KK, initial suggestion shows that even in KK tinggi, bukan sebab mungkin banyak juga lah, mungkin. Tapi I also suspect many of them come from rural areas, datang ke bandar dan dia tinggal di tempat yang satu rumah sama-sama perumahan mahal and all this they are working, kan? Shows that quite high incidence of child marriage lah. Then so we also doing programs di bandar juga, macam tahun lalu dan tahun ini lah kan akan membuat bengkel untuk kesegaran untuk pekerja-pekerja muda lah di bandar-bandar.
I'm sure those people who are following this children can go they are the native leaders,
It's quite tough actually, because when I visited the mahkamah, quite a number of mahkamah nak negeri, the first reaction is, YB kami mau kawin yang muda, bahwa macam itu kan. So it's also already a barrier, but the good thing is, actually we don't even have a law yet, tapi dasar sudah dibuat oleh kerajaan Sabah itu kan, November, they already start talking about, tidak boleh yo tahu kasih kawin. So but that's the level first lah, tidak boleh. And then the next thing is can they can they give advice? So in the Latihan, kepada katwa-katwa adat ini, first thing they say, oh kasi kawin lang. I mean, that's the norm lang. So they have to overcome that first. So, sogit-sogit memang. Especially kalau dia hamil. Mesti kena dia tu sogit. Tapi sogit ini dia semestinya berarti kawin. Dia berlainan, kan? Untuk orang asal. So, itu pertama lah dia orang pemimpin ini mesti yang equip. Then you have to, we always tell them you are a judge. You are, you cannot color yourself based on what you think is should be done from norm. It must be because this is the right thing to do. So the first thing is to question them. So that's why the SOP is actually very, quite tight. And it's not going to ask the parents of the new children or children who want to get married. It has to be the children themselves applying. And that will be a difference. So hopefully the norm yang selalu bilang, what usually the parents will pressure, but all this time, I must say, even among our ministers, how to do this? It's because they scared that they will, ini malu dia orang bayar, actually not the children. Children ini mungkin tidak berapa tahu pun, maybe they're quite lost. But the parents said, kawinlah, they apply to the native court. Usually all this time, it's the parents who apply to the native court as if kawin the piana. Now it's going to be the children, and they're going to be interviewed. Okay, di mana kamu akan tinggal? Adakah kamu akan tinggal sendiri atau di parents? Okay, then they assess from the economic point.